This is Gio from Rock and Roll Sussex County. Today we have John Papps from Cranford, New Jersey, who's now in Sussex. John, what do you play in your band?
I play guitar, I sing, and I also play bass guitar.
Awesome. How long are you a musician?
I've been playing guitar since the year 2000, so about 22 years, which is crazy to think about.
Nice. What genre do you perform and listen to?
My preferred genre is pop punk. I definitely enjoy the pop punk.
I think we all like that.
Agreed. Yeah. I'm among my brethren here. I'll play anything pretty much top 40 country. I respect all kind of music. I mean, I'll listen to even some crazy stuff like EDM and chill, like stuff like that. So
nice. Any tattoos?
I have no tattoos, and I'm actually proud of it. I have no desire to get any tattoos. When I was younger, I pierced up my face, but you can't tell now.
So, oh, okay.
Yeah, I had my lip, my eyebrow, my ears, all that jazz.
Do you have a day job?
I do. I'm a social worker by day. I work with children and families, and I actually enjoy that very much.
Very cool. Any hobbies outside of music?
Basically, learning home improvement. I purchased a home out here in Wantage about 2 years ago. So, between that and mowing my large lawn, those are my hobbies. Well, actually, my real main things is being a father or two. That's probably my most claim to fame.
Nice.
So, spending time with my kids, you know, coaching. I do basketball and stuff like that. So, playing basketball also is another hobby outside of everything else, and most importantly, being a loving husband, because you got to give the wife a shout out, or you're gonna hear grief when you get home.
There you go.
Love you, Rachel.
Who are your inspirations as far as music?
I mean, they had to have started when I was very young with the Beach Boys. So Brian Wilson, their principal songwriter, just a musical genius. Other parts of his life he had struggled with, as it's been very well documented. So I grew up with the Beach Boys. I'm a harmony lover. I also, more recently, you know, in my years where I started getting into the whole pop punk scene, Mike Herrera of MXPX has been a big influence. Super nice guy. I've met him a few times. He's invited me up on stage. I sang with them once many, many years ago. I think it was 2002, believe it or not, way back when. Let's see, Chris Rowe from the Atari is another super nice guy. I think you know Chris as well. So from the Atari's.
Yeah, Chris he's in my group.
Yeah, I know. I think I saw him in there. He was always been a big influence for me.
Cool.
Loved his earlier album, So Long a Story. Even some of the later stuff, like Welcome the Night, was really good. Matt Thiessen of band Reliant K, amazing songwriter. So he was definitely a big influence on me. And then just bands like Goldfinger, Mest, Unwritten Law, Blink 182. Those are like my big wheelhouse bands that I really, you know, that were my influence.
Are you on Spotify or Bandcamp?
I am not. I have not yet crossed into that that level yet. So I eventually should. I don't have a bunch. I have a bunch of songs written. I just don't have a bunch recorded. So you know, I'll hopefully be getting that around, or you know, I'll be giving you and our buddy Neil some rough demos for critique. So.
All right. What's your hometown?
Well, I grew up in Cranford, and then after Cranford, so I 20 years born and raised, so Cranford was my real house. I don't really identify Cranford anymore. It's changed so much since I was there, and I realized I was like a country boy at heart, but I moved out to Warren County after I went to Rutgers, and then when I became a father, I moved to West Milford. So then I was up there, and then I became up to Wantage. So that's kind of where I'm at. I've really embraced being out here in the community, and I definitely like, you know, I'm proud to call this place home.
Nice. What's your favorite drink?
My favorite drink? That's a tough one. I am a very eclectic functional. No, I'm not gonna say that. I'm a very eclectic drinker. Probably my go-to staple, as you guys have seen when I'm playing at early American Tavern, is Vodka Club Splashy Cran. Yeah, just enjoy that. I'll pretty much I'll try anything. I'm not big on the sugary stuff, but that's my go-to as I drink a beer.
And your band's names?
So my band that I'm primarily in, well, I do solo is John Papps of the PS Experiment. I do the PS Experiment Duo. We have the PS Experiment Trio. So that's the full band. And then I'm also on a band that's in hiatus with a gentleman named Chris Holmes. He's with the band Warp Speed. We're just on hiatus. I've been doing the PSX thing. He's doing a band called White Shores Original. They're really making some noise down in the greater Philadelphia area. So I wish nothing, Chris, but not the best, nothing but the best of luck. But also got to give a shout out to Brian Shepard and Kyle Dosick of the PS Experiment Trio, because I've been playing with Brian for a very long time, and you know we've become very close friends of the year. And Kyle's been nothing but a great addition over the last year to the band.
Nice. What's your next move in music?
My next move is just playing more originals. Playing shows.
You have a tour this summer?
We have a whole bunch of. Dungeon dates actually coming up. We have, I'll be at the, those of you in the Lehigh Valley, I'll be at the Easton Wine Project this Saturday night from 7 to 10. Then I'll be also Lehigh Valley on next Friday the 15th. I will be at the Copperhead Grill, and I believe that's Bethlehem. And then I will be at my local guys, which is one of my favorite places to play because the staff and the bartenders are so amazing. The Brick and Brew in Franklin, New Jersey. So me and not the trio, Kyle can't make that, but me and Brian will be there playing on Saturday the 16th. So if you guys are around, please come out. We'd love to see you, support you. We're a very interactive type of band. We like to integrate the audience, guest singers, guest guitarists, requests. So we try to make it a party, fun atmosphere, and a good time.
Awesome, awesome.
Thank you.
What advice would you give to a young aspiring musician?
I would explain, especially if their chops aren't up to snuff yet, you got to just work through it. You got to stay with it. I still remember those times where my hands were just killing me trying to learn the guitar. And I'm not like a shredder. I'm not an amazing guitarist. I'm a solid rhythm guitarist. I got a few leads up my sleeve. But it's one of those things. You just got to stick with it. Immerse yourself in, the guitar, the music. If it's songwriting, obviously just start breaking down songs that you love, listening to them in different ways. One of my favorite podcasts is actually Chris DeMakes, a podcast there where they... Less Than Jake. Yeah, they go over, they bring on a new artist every week, and most of it's very popular hit songs. Like, for example, I mentioned Matt Thiessen. He was on, I think, 2 weeks ago, and they literally totally deconstructed his song Be My Escape by Reliant K, which was like a huge hit for them back in like the mid-2000s. And it's just really cool because it gives you different ideas, and I find it to be very inspiring. And also just getting with other musicians and getting together, collaborating, songwriting, that would be my best advice to someone that's, wanting to do what I do or beyond what I do,
Oh, very nice. Cool. Mm-hmm. Well, that's a wrap. This is John Papps from Cranford, New Jersey, now in Sussex.
I'm from Wanted. Let's say I'm John from Wanted. What's this, the buzzword? I don't identify with Cranford anymore. No, but seriously, I've been working up in Sussex County for the past 11 years, but I really love it out here. So I like to call Sussex my home and not Cranford anymore. But sorry about my C-town peeps. I do apologize.
John from Sussex.
All right, thanks again. Thanks, Gio. I appreciate you having me, and I look forward to seeing you guys again soon.
All right, okay, now you're going to play a song for us?
Yeah, let me grab the guitar. I'll do an original because that's what I eventually want to do more of.
That's great.
All right, this song's called I Miss You. right, thanks everybody. JP from the PS Experiment. For now, here's a cover song by Green Day.
In the Sussex County music community.
Now, as you mentioned in the interview, I'm a little new to the area, so I do not have the biggest sample size to get data from. I definitely have checked out some. You have actually turned me on to Mike Lawler. He's a really amazing musician.
Right on.
Does a lot of different cool stuff. I like that. And also, the Harrisons are a real talented duo. Actually, just by chance, I was trick or treating in Andover Borough, and I ran into. The gentleman, I can't remember, I won't call him Mr. Harrison, because I sound like a douchebag.
Christian,
that's his name. I met him, and I was talking with him, and he was a super cool guy, and we chat a little bit, but just random. I'm like, he's like, I do music. I'm like, oh, me too. He's like, the Harrisons. I'm like, oh, I've seen you guys all over. You guys are awesome. So yeah, those would be the two I have, but I'm looking forward to making new friends in the area, and playing music, jamming, writing songs. So I know that we're going to definitely connect with some new folks, and hopefully, we'll have some more good music coming out of the area soon.
Absolutely. Sounds good.
All right.